This summer, the godfather of punk, Iggy Pop, released his Brick by Brick album, which he thinks is his most mature work to date.
I've been kind of forced into growing a lot in the last few years, probably growing up or something. And I didn't want to ignore that anymore in my work. I didn't want to do, I basically just didn't want to make album. I don't know what I could say, excuse me, you know. But, you know, I just wanted to talk about what was really going on in my emotions and in what I'd see around me. Just basically, basic human need to say what's really on your mind.
The life we live is tricky, tricky. I love my home and my family. Who's gonna love you when the mountain gets steep? We're gonna make it in a Jeep. Home, boy.
Critics have been quick to call attention to the softer and more introspective side of the new album's lyrics. But where does this unexpected vulnerability come from?
I've always tried. I mean, that's kind of why I got into music, because the idea was, I thought that was a way in which I could put some of myself into my life so that I wouldn't be spending my time as a robot in somebody else's machine. I didn't want to be like, you know, a widget maker. With a fancy title.
We are played for suckers all the time. Phony rock and roll, it's a crime. I don't want to dip myself in trash.
As well as a mellower lyrical approach, Iggy has opted for a gentler musical touch, a long way from today's tyrannical electronic beat.
I think groups that play electronic music will use the distortion as a kind of, it's like a thumb suck. It's like a security blanket or something, or like a false armor to, you know, puff them up to make what's really not that good an idea sound better, to make you more secure. And I really like that sometimes. I like a bit of the old buzz, you know, I do, but I wanted to try some things without it too, which makes you feel more like you're naked.
This is Iggy and the Stooges playing live in the 70s. Hollywood director Oliver Stone wanted them to reform just to shoot one scene for his film on Jim Morrison, lead singer of The Doors. Iggy, however, wanted no part of it, perhaps because he has such good memories of the first time around.
Sure, yeah, you bet I do. You bet I do. It was a great band, and it was a provincial band. It was pristine and untouched by any reality whatsoever. We were totally out in the world of pure art. That's why we got clobbered. That's why we got up. But we were it.
Iggy Pop!
Iggy's new album is Don Was from the band Was Not Was. At a recent concert of theirs in Los Angeles, Iggy was the special guest. Don Was remembers being a big fan of the Stooges.
Always admired Iggy Pop. I mean, he's a big hero. I saw his first few gigs when back in Detroit when they were known as the Psychedelic Stooges. He came and played at our high school even. And I don't think that in all the ensuing years I've seen a more exciting performer. He's certainly an original. I was really pleased that at this point out he's very lucid. He's a guy who's pushed, I mean, probably everything you've ever heard about him is true.
Life is crazy.
Meanwhile, Iggy's new single, Candy, pairs him with the B-52's Kate Pearson in a duet originally written for Chrissie Hynde.
Candy, baby.
elsewhere on the album, Iggy declares that phony rock and roll is a crime. In fact, he's got quite a few pet hates about modern America.
Football, people with red faces jockeying themselves to death, hamburgers, don't smoke here, you know, sort of thing. You know, there are these cliches, basically, that are all, they're just foisted over and over through the media until people just, yeah, man. And now rock and roll has become one more. And it's basically just,
yeah, man, rock out. Yeah, you know, leather jacket. Yeah.
You say that you don't like it. Well, maybe it's just my life. So you live yours and I'll keep mine. Rolling like a wheel through the city on the edge of the night. And when the black rain's down in this cold gray town, I'll be waiting. Waiting at the edge of the night.
I think that were I stupid enough to pander to that and say, oh yeah, wild, then I would be a lesser person than I am. And I don't want to be that. And nobody's going to paint me into that corner. Nobody.